Hi everyone, I'm Jayne at Rock and Worms, and tonight we're doing an update on the indoor tabletop pre-composting bins. And I'm pretty excited to show you this tonight because I'm going to share with you a secret ingredient, I would even say a secret weapon, to take your pre-composting to the next level. So let's start with the cream bin, which is going to show you how the secret weapon works, or the result of deploying the secret ingredient. Here it is, 116 degrees in the indoor compost bin. I have never gotten this level of temperature with an indoor bin before. I usually top out at 111 degrees. I have had pockets of 113 degrees, but 116 is the best I've ever had. And this is fantastic. And I'll explain more why it's so good as we go along tonight. Okay, so let me just open up this cream bin for you for a minute so you can just see what's going on. Not that it's very exciting to look at, but it is important to see. One of the first things you're going to notice is that I changed out the plastic bag that I used to have as the top onto this bin. It was an experiment to see if the plastic bag worked or not as a top on the pre-composting bin, and it was a complete fail. I would not do that again, and I would not recommend you do it at all. The reason being, I believe, is it wasn't giving the compost mixture here enough air. We want aerobic bacteria. Ooh, it's very warm in my hand. We want aerobic material, aerobic bacteria, excuse me, operating in this bin. So we need air. And with the plastic side of the bins, with the plastic top mostly covering it, I don't believe the material, the microbial organism were getting enough air. It was just being starved for air. I had almost no activity going on in this bin after 5 days of initially mixing it up and fixing my dry pockets. I had no activity. And then I switched out the plastic for the screen and the shred. And within 24 hours, I started to see heat rise. And the only difference was the amount of air that was getting into the bin. Okay, so that's important. Then after I fixed that issue, I, you know, let it warm up for a couple more days, but it just wasn't heating up as fast as I wanted it to do. So that's when I decided to use the secret ingredient. So let's move on to the blue bin here. I'm gonna close this up for in just a second here so I can move this out of the way. So I can move the blue bin in and we can employ the same tactic on the blue bin that I did on this cream bin to get that fantastic rise in temperature. Now while I'm doing this, let me just talk to you a little bit, goes this way, about why the rise in temperature is so great. I'm putting this over here. Okay, the reason is because after a certain temperature, basically 113 degrees, you start getting different bacteria active in your bins. It goes from being mesophilic bacteria to thermophilic bacteria. It just means different bacteria are working because the temperatures are hotter. And these hotter loving bacteria work faster to break down the organics that are in your bin. And breaking down the organics in your bin, the cardboard and the ground coffee grounds, is what we're doing this whole process for, to break down those materials. Now this bin is about 100 degrees and it's right on the edge between being stable and being active. This material right now would be perfectly okay to use in your worm bins as pre-composted bedding. Yes, it's 100 degrees. It's a little warm for your worms. But as you take this material out and you spread it thinly across your bin, it's going to lose a lot of that heat and therefore be fine for your worms. But of course, keep an eye on the temperature because we don't want to cook our worms. One of the things I want you to look at, if the cameraman can get in a little bit closer, see these little dots and clumps? I know it's very hard, but I believe these are microbes. So this is showing you, and you can even see like little pockets in here. This is showing you the microbial activity that's going on in your bin. It's not that same bright orange that you get at the higher temperatures, but this is good stuff. Your worms are gonna go crazy for this. This is gonna be particularly effective in breeding bins. So we're gonna set this aside for a minute because we're going to mix the next layer of materials to reactivate the blue bin and kick it up to the next heating cycle level. And again, hopefully get that super heat rise to 116 degrees. Okay, here it is, the secret weapon. Oh my God, what is that? That is the blob from outer space. If you're old like me, you might remember The Blob was a movie. It starred Steve McQueen many years ago. What this is baker's yeast, okay? And you buy it in your grocery store. It's usually sold in a 3-pack, but they do sell it bulk if you want. But this is 3 packs of baker's yeast. Let me put this down for a second. Let me show you what the package looks like. This is the package I use. I got it at Aldi's, but the packages all look amazingly similar with the yellow surround with a red banner across the front, regardless of whether you're buying Fleshman's or something like that, or some other store brand. So it comes in a 3-strip, and what you're gonna do is you're going to empty the yeast into a container. I would suggest a bigger one than this one. Add warm water, like the instructions on the back of the packet will tell you what to do, and you add in sugar. And again, the instructions will tell you exactly what to do, and that's what I did. Now I'm gonna mix this in, and I'm gonna be kind of slap happy here because I want to just give you the idea. Obviously you can scrape it all out very nicely when you're at home doing this, which I will come back and do so I get every last amount of yeast working for me. Okay, now why yeast? Yeast is a microbe, and it's actually a fungus. And funguses are particularly effective in breaking down fibrous organic material. Well, guess what cardboard is? Cardboard is fibrous organic carbon material. So adding yeast in is the perfect secret ingredient to kick your pre-composting up to the next level. Now, what is in here to begin with is 3 gallons of shredded cardboard and 2 gallons of coffee grounds. And that's it for right now, okay? Now, the 3 gallons to 2 gallons is obviously higher than the standard 70% carbon to 30% nitrogen, but because we are, one, adding a lot of microbes right into the mix with the yeast, we're also going to be combining this when we're done mixing it up into our blue bin, which is already full of microbes because that's how we got it to the maximum temperature it did reach, which, by the way, was 113 degrees. And then it settled down after a day or two to 111 degrees, which is my normal max. That's why, again, 116 on the cream bin was so exciting. I'd never gotten that hot before. Now, this is still pretty dry, so I'm going to grab some regular water. I have well water, so I don't have to dechlorinate it. But if you have to, all you need to do again is set it out for 24 to 48 hours and the chlorine will dissipate and your water will be safe to use in your worm bins. Now, the reason I'm working this in a mortar tray, but any, you know, appropriately sized bin will work, is because it's easier. It's less work for me to mix this all up in this smaller amount and then add it to my big bin than it is to add all the ingredients separately to the big bin and then try to mix it all up there. Why not save us a little bit of time and effort and physical exertion? Because I'm telling you, this is the end of a long day for me and I'm getting a little tired. So if I can save myself some energy, I'm going to do it. And I still want to add in a little bit more liquid. This is molasses water. It's like a maybe 2 teaspoons or so of blackstrap molasses. I take that back. It's not blackstrap. It's grandma's molasses. It's unsulfured. Unsulfured is the important part. And again, what the molasses is sugar. And it's going to feed the yeast in here. And it's also going to give another food boost to the microbes that are in the blue bin when we add this into it. Okay. Also, you can see by mixing it in this smaller bin for this second heating cycle, it's much easier for me to make sure I don't have any dry pockets, because that did cause me some problems my first go around. Okay, let's see how the moisture is. Yep, you can hear it. It could probably take a little bit more, but it's good for now. So what we're gonna do is I'm gonna try to do this way as opposed to doing handfuls, and we'll see how big a mess I make. Okay, that's pretty good, right? All right. So now what we're gonna do, you know what? I don't actually smell anything. I don't even smell the coffee, and I should be smelling coffee. That's interesting. I actually like that I'm not smelling the coffee. I'm not a coffee drinker at all. And the smell doesn't bother me, but it's not exactly a favorite either. So anyways, what I'm going to do is just mix this in as best I can. Because remember, what we just added was already mixed. And what we have in this bin is already mixed. So I don't have to go crazy on it. And those yeast will move down through the blue bin over time. Mixing it up just allows that to happen faster because I am impatient to get that temperature rise I'm hoping for. Now I will say I am smelling just a little bit of sour, just a tiny bit. And that means I could be starting to develop an anaerobic pocket down here in the corner, which is not unusual because gravity does move all that liquid that we add to the bin as we go along down into the bottom where it can pool and become anaerobic. So I'm actually even gladder that I'm digging through this bin a bit and breaking up any type of anaerobic pockets that might be developing before they get out of hand. Okay. All right. Now, honestly, this could probably use another 10 or 15 minutes of my attention in mixing it all up. And since I did smell that little bit of sourness, I do want to take the time to get down into the corners and make sure I address any type of anaerobic activity that might be going on. I am not feeling pooling water though. There's no pools of wet down in the bottom. But since I can smell it a little bit, I want to fix it before it gets out of control. All right, so you get the idea. And I'm going to spend a little bit more time after this video concludes to make sure I go through the whole bin. Okay, so the last thing I want to mention here in particular is you can see now with this addition of the 3 gallons of cardboard and the 2 gallons of nitrogen that I've increased the mass. As the decomposition process goes on, the mass decreases. And what we're doing is pumping up the mass again, along with the addition of the cardboard and the nitrogen and the yeast to just power slam it into the next level of decomposition. All right. So I'm going to actually leave you here. What I would normally do would be to put the burrito top back on and close it up. But I do want to spend the extra, like I said, 15 minutes or so going through this bin and making sure everything is mixed in correctly before I put it away for the night. So I hope this has helped you. The yeast is really, I think, a great add to the process. And you can add the yeast in at any part during your bin setup. You can add it in right in the beginning. You don't have to wait to the second cycle if you want to. I do suggest you wait to the second cycle because it gives your bin a chance to get established and work on that 3-to-1 ratio. And then when you come back for the second heat cycle, you can do a higher nitrogen ratio to the carbon. Because remember, I did 3 gallons of carbon to 2 gallons of nitrogen. So I did add more nitrogen. And I can get away with that because I'm boosting the microbial activity with the addition of the yeast. Okay? So that's it. I hope you found this, again, helpful and informative. And we'll check in again probably in 2 or 3 days and see if the temperature rise is what we hope it to be. All right, so you have a good rest of your day and I'll see you next time. I'm Jayne, yours in the dirt. Good night.